Okay, here we're going to make a fender back switch ball. And you can use any size tubing you want. The smaller you do, the tighter your wigwags are going to be. This is the size of my pinky, a little smaller. Usually I go a little thinner than this, so I'm going to go ahead and go a little thinner than that. And I did this on purpose as well, so you can see I pull it down a little bit if you need to, or if you want to. So now that I got it pulled down, I'm going to let it cool down just a little bit. But I'll start in the middle. And the trick is to get it not too juicy, but just juicy enough. So it's able to bend. So that tells me that that's good. And then I just kind of ride the flame a little bit. When I need it, I should go a little bit more or a little bit less. Now I got that bent up. So you can see that thing all bent up. It's good. If you can see that. And before you go to the next one, you just kind of want to wait for it to cool down. So blow on it. But I think that one's good to go. And you want to go about the middle of about one flame away. And you see me like pause there, and I did that because that one color, the viscosity is a little bit more, or else it's a little thicker. I think it's mostly the viscosity, it's just a little bit thicker. This is a piece that we pulled here at Elevate Premier. So there I go again. Again, the whole trick, always, 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 not too juicy, just enough to bend it. You want to feel a lot of friction in there. And then if you get off a little bit, you can twist it up whichever way. So it's not really critical, but you still want to try to get it as even as possible. So you can always bend it right back up. So I know that's bendable now, so I'll give it a little bit more to let the heat soak. So I'm going to go ahead and bend it. Now one thing you don't want to do is you don't want to pull. You don't want to push. You might feel like you're pushing. And that's kind of an important thing too, but you're not really pushing, you're just making sure you're definitely not pulling. So it looks like I did kind of a poor job of getting my line in the middle to start out with. So I'm going to put another line to my left here. Usually I get a 5 or a 7 or a 9. I'm not going to do nothing there. I'm just waiting for it to cool down. There's just too much in the front there, and I don't want that much of a spin. I'd rather have another wigwag. Okay, so I'm going to turn this up and blow this stuff out. And the trick here again, everything as always is you need it juicy hot, not too wet. Sometimes you really want to get it really sloppy wet, depending on what you're doing. when you're worried about your lines and everything, you definitely want to do that just enough. So here I'm letting it kind of shrink in and as well, get a little bit thicker. I'll blow it here, usually I don't do this. So, and then the reason it's getting, you can see it darker there, where I just heated it up, it's because the viscosity is a little bit more. So it takes a little more heat to get it how you really want it. Different colors, different viscosities. Or if a color rod was slightly thicker, it'd be a little bit more color in there than what was next to it. Usually it's because it's different viscosities. So how to prevent that is you can use all kinds of things with the same viscosity. Or you can mix it up, go light, heavy, light, heavy, light, heavy. And that keeps it pretty flowing nice. You see yourself spinning it like it kind of was getting a little off center there? Well, just re-straighten it up. Okay. So now we're going to give this a nice little spin on the front. Everybody loves a little spin on there. I know I did. The key here too, slow. Slow but fast. All glass. Slow but fast. Slow but fast. Take your time. Don't get it too juicy. Don't let it melt in on itself too much. Some of the colors will overlap on each other, and that don't look too good. Thinning it after just a little bit. I like to get it thin and then pull my tip off. The tip here is, don't let that shrink down too much and you should be alright. So there we go, getting it all down into there. I think I dazed off a little bit, looking at the pretty glass. But now I'm gonna just make sure I get the glass really, same wall thickness. Very, very important. Put it right in your water bowl if you want. I've seen that. Well, you can, when you heat it up, you can see your lines, so if you have different colors, you can pick in between the lines. You're good. Mine's a whole bunch of red, so I can pick any one. that I want in there. But I try to pick the pretty much the center one. So when it blows out, everything's good. When you open these up, you want to pretty much open whatever your size is that you want, like, stick to it. Mine's not quite a half inch, and I think all my balls that, all my everything like that. Some people go bigger, some people go smaller. So then I'll pony up to it, make sure I got some heat in there. Then we're going to do another twist on this side. I'll turn my plane down just a little bit so I can use it to twist it better. A little more control. And another thing I always do is I just always go opposite of what my last switch was, just because. Here's the end of that. Now, we'll blow that out because I like it thin again. Use a soapette, or you could use a, you can make one out of glass. I've had that for about 9 years now. Flat shield made it, they make a great tool. I got a flat shield here. I love glass shield. Glass shield is good. When I'm doing fine stuff, I don't have it up, but when you're doing big stuff, it's definitely wanted. And less is more, just heat it up. Get that stuff going down onto it. Fall into itself. There's a switch ball, and they're happy with it. Nice round hole, nice and flat, so it'll go up to your next. You don't want the color to bleed out, you want it to stay straight up and down in there. And bada bing, bada bang.